2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Check. Good.
Thank you. Test. Let's give it up for Team Freeze!
We hope the priests are still breathing in 9 minutes. Coach Libby has them in tip-top shape already. Playoff four.
Jesus.
Thank you to Chaminade Middle School for hosting us yet again for the annual pre-seminarian basketball extravaganza. The fundamentals of moral theology with the players at this time. Very tough to splendor, the splendor of truth. Capacity crowd here early already tonight. Our wonderful sponsors here tonight, Chaminade Middle School, hosting us yet again. Amazing facilities. Thank you to the principal and the president and everyone. The Sarens, the Sarah Club is always unveiling in their prayerful support for seminarians' vocations. Thank you to the Sarens. The Knights of Columbus are serving our food tonight. We have hot dogs and nachos and chips and drinks and all of the healthy things that you didn't eat on Super Bowl Sunday that you'll eat tonight there in the snack bar. Thank you to the Knights of Columbus. We have the Boy Scouts Troop 92 from Our Lady of Lourdes Church who will be our color guard tonight. Thanks to the Boy Scouts. Amazing. And it's never time to pre-plan. Thank you to Catholic Cemeteries. Thank you for Catholic Cemeteries for their support tonight as well. Of course, thanks to the Vocations Office, Father Mike Perucho and Father Peter Salcedo, the Vocation Directors, Maria Vargas and Alex Salcedo, and those who help in the office at the Chancery at the ACC. And of course, our amazing seminarians from St. John's Seminary. Can we hear it for the St. John's Seminarians? And our college seminarians from Queen of Angels Center for Priestly Formation in Torrance. Here for them. in this amazing capacity crowd out here on a Friday night. Thank you for your support. Just 30 seconds until the introduction of the players tonight. This beautiful Friday evening. Our last meat-filled Friday till Easter. Ash Wednesday next week, if you can believe. Lent is beginning. Of course. Thanks to our referees here, Keith Weiser and Alfonso Nunez, both counselors at Rancho San Antonio Boys Home, doing amazing work with those boys. Are you ready for some basketball? I think I just violated trademarks there.
Good evening, everyone. Let's hear for Team Priest and Team Seminarians. Woo! My brothers and sisters, it's a great blessing to be with you this evening as we gather here at Chaminade Middle School for our fourth annual Seminarian versus Priest basketball game. Last year, as you know, the Seminarians took the trophy. Where the Seminarians at? Right over here. Let's give them a big hand for that. But I think we have a lot of people rooting for our priests. Is that right? So hopefully our Seminarians, they've been training for the last 6 months, so we are very excited to have them here with us and have you with us as well. Thank you for being here on a Friday night to honor and to promote and to pray for vocations to the priesthood and religious life. We thank you and we welcome you. My name is Father Peter Salcedo. I am one of the associate vocation director here for the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, and it's a great blessing to be with you today. We want to just remind you of a couple things. We have concessions available. If anybody of you are hungry, you want some hot dogs, some chips, some sodas, they're to your right-hand side. Go ahead and pass by there and get some food. There's also restrooms over here to your left. If you need to use the restroom, please feel to do so. Today we are here to honor and promote and pray for vocations. If any of you are taking pictures, make sure to hashtag us at #LAVocations. And in order to honor our vocations, we want to honor our men who were just ordained priests. So I invite you to put your attention over here to our screen.
So, my brothers, how many different paths have you walked to reach this day? When you will be called a priest of Jesus Christ, a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. Guillermo, Juan Cesar, Juan, Ramon, Camille, Daniel, Justin, and Daniel. In the gospel today, Jesus, as he's praying, he's referring to each one of you personally and with great love. Today, you're being ordained as successors of the 12 men at the Last Supper's table. Those 12 men whom Jesus consecrated, whom he called simply my friends. We all remember those stories about the apostles, how they argued about which of them was the greatest, how two of them asked to be seated at his right hand and his left. The priesthood is not about statues. It's about sanctity and service. It is about holiness and helping other people. Brothers, Jesus longs to do great things to you. He has given everything for you. He's calling you today to give everything for him, to lay down your lives for the gospel. These times, my dear brothers and sisters, call for courage and sacrifice. But most of all, these times call for love. Jesus gave us life so that we can share our life with him, so that we can know him and love him and walk with him on this earth and follow him to heaven. Soon, you will be at this altar, offering the sacrifice of his body and blood, his soul and divinity to God our Father, interceding for you people as Jesus did. So I hope that you never lose that sense of Eucharistic amazement, that awareness of what a privilege it is to bring Jesus to your people. And when you raise up your arms to give a blessing, I hope you will always recall how Jesus stretched out his arms on the cross to offer himself as a sacrifice for others, to heal and to make peace. And let us especially ask Jesus every day that he will call many more men to this beautiful vocation of being his priests. Let us ask our Blessed Mother Mary to walk with our new priest and help them to open their hearts to follow and love her Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Seminarian team just last year. So let's give it up for Father Ramon. And my brothers and sisters, it's a great blessing, as we always do, to start with the most important thing that we can do with anything. And I want to invite Father Mike Perucho, who is the vocation director for the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. Let's give it up for him to lead us in prayer.
Before we pray, I think it's always important to ask this very important question. Are you ready? All right, all right. So real quick, we got some giveaways. Who wants a free t-shirt? Come on, I can't hear you. They got t-shirts to give away. Come on. Yeah, come on, here we go. It is definitely a joy to be here with all of you for this fourth annual Priests versus Seminarians basketball game. And it's always important whenever we gather to always give thanks to our Almighty God. And so I invite us at this point to maybe just center ourselves, to quiet ourselves for a moment as we recognize the presence of God in our midst. And to begin, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks always for your presence. We thank you for all the blessings that we have received throughout our lives and throughout this year. We thank you for this opportunity to gather here today for this wonderful and fun and faith-filled night as we watch our priests and seminarians compete with one another on this court. In a special way, Lord, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit to sanctify this space. We ask you to watch over our players. May they be filled with great competitive spirit. Keep them free from all injury. And may they glorify you in all that they do on this court. And as we gather here today, as we experience laughter and joy, happiness and gladness, may we always know that you are here in our midst, that your Son, Jesus, continues to walk with us as he is the way, the truth, and the life, and that the Holy Spirit continues to guide us in all things. And so we ask your blessing upon all of us this day, that we may be under the protective mantle of our Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let's give it up for Father Mike. Father Mike, along with Father Sam, 4 years ago started our first priest versus seminarian basketball game, and we kept going, and so it's a great blessing once again to be here with you. I invite you to please stand as we prepare for the national anthem, which will be played by the one and only Father Matt Wheeler. Let's give it up for Father Matt.
Color guard, attention. Color guard, forward march. Color guard, halt. Color guard, present the colors. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag. Please remain standing for our national anthem.
that Jimi Hendrix at Woodstock?
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii ebre, a te suspiramus, gementes et pletes, in a lacrimarum vae. Ea ergo, advocata nostra, ios tuos, misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Ere Jesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis, os hoc exilium, os verde.
Let's hear it for Team Priests.
Woo!
We have a holy and talented group of priests here today. Introducing first, from St. John Vianney in Hacienda Heights, Father Joseph Choi. From the guitar to the hardwood, from Visitation Church in Los Angeles, Father Matthew Wheeler just did our national anthem. From Incarnation Church in Glendale, recently ordained last year, Father Ramon Reyes. From right here next door, Our Lady of Lourdes, Northridge, Father Filiberto Cortez. From St. Anselm in Los Angeles, Semper Fidelis, Father Fidelis. Not here yet. And our player coach from Christ the King in Los Angeles, Father Louis Song. And the starting five from Team Priests, from St. Gertrude in Bell Gardens, Father Justin, number four. secretary to go with him in Santa Clarita. They already know him, Father Jihoon Kim. From St. Helen in Southgate, that produced the great Father Peter Salcedo, our vocation director, Father Michael Masteler. And our youngest priest here, from Tepeyac House in Los Angeles, Father Darren Merlino. And from St. Pancratius in Lakewood, Father Andrew Jones. Let's hear it for Team Priest. Are we ready for Team Seminarians? Uh-oh. Is it Darth Vader and Luke Skywalker? Oh, that's some serious looks. Oh, Christian says no. The Pride of Glendora. Team Seminarians seem like serious business. Let's hear it for Team Seminary coming off the bench tonight from Maria Regina in Gardena. Guard Anthony.
I don't want to change the world. I just got to be myself. I don't
from A to Z in the USA, from Azusa, St. Francis of Rome, Wayfong Joseph Tonger. Here in the valley, St. Joseph of Orca, Winneka, forward, Thomas Blue. Right next door to the seminary, St. Mary Magdalene de Camarillo, Pepe Sinkowicz, number 11. And your team seminarian starting five from St. Christopher, West Covina, guard Michael Lee. Forward, St. Joseph Carpinteria, Jose Pacheco, cousin of Isaiah Pacheco from the world champion Kansas City Chiefs. From Good Shepherd, Beverly Hills, Michael Rogan. Pride of Glendora, St. Dorothy, Center, Tommy Green. Making his debut this year on Team Seminarian, now at St. John Seminary, Christian, Mary Star, the C in San Pedro. And leading yet again as coach, moral theologian, overall just great, great person, Coach Libby, Dr. Elizabeth Reichert. Assisting pre-theology from the Diocese of Orange, Alan Hooker. And Carlos Taban from Incarnation in Glendale. With the magic wands. Should we play some ball?
Let's hear it for our priests and seminarians.
I think we can be a little louder than that. Team Priest, let's cheer for them.
Well, if you're just joining us now, my name is Stephen Watson. I'm a fourth-year seminarian over at St. John's, and I'm joined here by, I'll go ahead and have them introduce themselves. We have our other seminarian.
So, hi, I'm once again, I'm back. My name is Miguel Cabrera. I'm in my third year of theology. Joining us for the first time,
Father Matt Murphy, pastor over at Our Lady of Malibu, and I was invited here because the seminarians that are doing this commentary were so biased last year that I figured I'd invite myself, actually.
When you say invited, yeah. Let's let the people know here what we mean by invited.
Let's define our terms here, Father. No.
Yes, invited as in I'm coming to do this. No, we're very happy to have Father Father Matt here with us tonight. This is a great tradition that we've been going now for, this is the fourth year we've done this, minus brief hiatus from COVID, and we really are honored to have a priest joining us this time. Some of you who tuned in with us last year might remember an M. Murphy who kept leaving these comments, and we couldn't quite figure out who was so unbiased towards the seminarians. Well, he's here in person with us tonight, and we thank you guys for joining us. Like last year, we are going to be able to interact with you guys through different comments on our various live streams. We know there are a couple of different live streams going on at LA Catholics, the Facebook page, the Vocations page, Archbishops. So we're going to be kind of going between those. So feel free to leave comments, shout-outs to different players, both priests and seminarians, and we'll try to read those out as they come up. So thank you. I'm going to hand it over to my co-commentators here because they know the stuff about basketball, and it started. So let's go.
Well, we have a tip by the priest out of bounds. So we're going to set our referees for the game. Our welcome to
Michael Lee. That's great. It's nice to have somebody up here who knows quite a bit about basketball. The first time I was asked to give a commentary on this, I said, that's great, but it'll be my first basketball game. And every year I add one more basketball game to that number. It's this one in particular. But it is great to have that. So what can you tell us about what you expect to see tonight from both the priests and the seminarians, Father?
Competitive game. It always is. It always is a competitive game. And we won't see the best quality basketball, but we're going to see competitive basketball.
And we're going to have fun while we're watching.
We're going to have a lot of fun.
That's for sure. As mentioned during those introductions, we are joined by one of our seminary faculty members as the coach for the seminarian team. Miguel, can you tell us a little bit about Dr. Reichart and maybe how she came to be the coach for the seminarian team here?
Dr. Riker is, she's actually one of my professors currently, but she went to Franciscan University of Steubenville, taught high school in New York, and was a coach for the high school girls basketball team. And then after that, she studied in Spain, got a doctorate from Rome in moral theology, and now she's our moral theology professor at the seminary. And assisting her is Alan, who's a seminarian in second year of philosophy from Orange. And you might remember him from the game last year. Carlos Buckets Tobone is also joining them, assisting them coaching.
That's great.
From all those buckets he scored last year.
Last year we were promised buckets merch, but I didn't see that on display anywhere in this
stadium. I went to Home Depot, and they wouldn't sponsor us. That was the real issue here. In fact, just saying Home Depot, we could get in trouble. I don't think that's actually true. But let's see if we can get some buckets right now here for the priest.
So just to catch everybody up, we had Justin Olayup a couple minutes ago, and now we have two free throws by Mike Masteler and foul by Christian on the baseline. So seminarians are having a little bit of trouble controlling the ball down here.
It's turning into soccer, it looks like. Like we've got Christian and Father Masteler there trying to get the ball here. Possession will go to the priests here. Father Justin O. Number 12, Father Masteller, behind the three-point line here.
I have to say it's nice to have all these ball handlers on the Priest team, because the first year when I played, I think we had Andrew Chung and that was it. Father Andrew Chung and that was it. And it was very tough to play a game that way.
Yeah.
Now we've got three or four of them on the team, which is great.
So you put Seminary.
There we go. Bucket by Jose Pacheco.
We got some points on the board for Team Seminary now. Yeah, 50%. They're used to being at about 50%, I would say. But that's in classes.
Seminarian on the rebound.
A no-look shot by the Priest. There doesn't go.
Now Michael Krogan, who just passed to Jose Pacheco. Michael Krogan has a large crowd here cheering him on from his internship parish at St. Kateri. I think it takes up about a third of the stadium, or the third of the stands on the other side there.
And I'm very proud of that, because that's my home parish. That's where I came from.
St. Kateri, shout out to St. Kateri. I don't know if there's even anyone left from the parish that would be watching this at home, because they're all here. No, it's a large parish. There's probably a lot of them watching.
Father Vaughn and Father Jihoon did something amazing this year. They invited all of the altar servers to the game. They paid for their tickets.
Wow.
And then the altar servers obviously came with their families. So
if you're watching this from home right now and you're an altar server, you should be asking, why isn't my priest doing this? Father Matt, where are your altar servers? No.
I wasn't playing, so they didn't.
Oh, there we go. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, in fact, St. Kateri has two players in the game. Their intern, Michael Krogan, and the associate pastor, Father Jihoon Kim. Father Jihoon actually played for a number of years on the seminarian team before he became a priest and joined the priest team now.
We have another bucket at the end, at the other end, by Father Mike Masteller.
There we go. I have to say, the priest team is looking pretty strong this year.
Three-point attack by Pacheco, error, and out of bounds.
And out of bounds. Father Justin taking up the court. Out to Father Chung here, number 32, to Mass, Father Masteller, number 12. Back to Father Chung. Fancy footwork there.
Oh,
and it is blocked.
Blocked shot by Christian. Very nice.
Keeping it inbounds. Coming down the court by Michael Krogan here. Back to Christian. Tommy Green in.
Tommy Green with a bucket.
And there we go. Score is now 4-6 with less than 5 minutes in the first quarter here. Again, Father Justin O taking it.
Oh, 3-point attempt by Owen. Air ball. Out of bounds. Why are you smiling at me? He just wanted to show we can do it at this end too, Miguel.
There we go. And Miguel, maybe we can get a quick check in here on some of our live streams. Do we have any comments?
Really quickly. Tommy had actually sent me a text earlier of some people he'd like to give a shout-out to.
Oh, that's great.
And so first, he'd like to give a shout-out to Father Ron Clark, and then also Kyle Kianapur. I'm hoping I pronounced that right. That's how he spelled it in the text message here. But he also wants to give a shout-out to his whole family, the parishioners at St. Dorothy's, who apparently are all watching the game live, having a watch party over at the parish. All the parishioners at St. Elizabeth, where he had his internship year, the Hillmans, Jackie Sherman, Father John, and all Tommy's friends.
All Tommy's, all my friends, yeah.
Although, why not give my own friends a shout-out, too?
That's okay. Yeah, let's give a shout-out to Miguel's friends here as well. Father Sam over there, who caught the ball from going into the stands, is the past vocation director who started the tradition of doing the basketball game and is giving the commentary for the court here. Father Sam, Father Matt, do you remember what parish Father Sam is at the moment?
Father Sam is down at St. Raymond's.
Okay, so let's give a shout out.
But he's also the chaplain at St. Matthias High School.
Oh, that's great. So we'll give a shout out here to anyone from St. Raymond's and St. Matthias High School. Father Jihoon.
The seminarians get the ball back.
Michael Che from the seminarian team. Stop possession from the priest. Take it down. Rebound. Michael Krogan tried to get it, and there's a foul there.
Father Sam appropriately quoting this Sunday's gospel.
There we go.
Very nice.
Good. Three players
from the looks.
And we've got some substitutions coming in for the priest. We have Father Ramon Reyes, who is recently, they're not even recently ordained, newly ordained. This is his first year playing for Team Priest. And we have a timeout from the team seminary. And coming on for the priest, did you see who the other substitution was?
Sorry?
Did you see who the other substitution was?
I saw Father Joseph Choi.
And Father Joseph Choi coming on as well. Here we go.
We got Damien right over here.
You know, one of the nice things about this is they give us a binder here of kind of some information about the priest and seminarian players. And some of them give us some really good information. Father Joseph Choi here is a fan of Our Lady of Lourdes, not just the parish, but Our Lady of Lourdes, Our Lady and Our Mother, right? And he is the associate pastor at St. John Vianney in Hacienda Heights, playing shooting guard over there. Father Andrew Chung on the priest team wants everyone to know that his favorite saint is St. John Paul II. That is great.
25 seconds.
And for those of you who are watching from home, we do have some half some timeout activities led by our vocation office, which is great to see our vocation team helping out. And some of the seminarians from Queen of Angels. We have George over there. And then we have Maria Vargas, who's part of the vocations office staff down at the Archdiocese. We really want to give a shout-out to Maria and Alex Saucedo from the vocations office, because in addition to Father Mike and Father Peter, they really are the heart of the vocations office. And when they're going out to the parishes for Sundays, they're going to the different schools for masses and events, it's not just Father Mike and Father Peter, but it really is the vocations office and the support of the ACC and Archbishop's office as well. So we want to thank them for being here and helping us out today. It's really great. Yeah. Looks like the priests are about to take it in.
And along with our vocations office, we have our regional contacts. And a couple of them are playing in this game. And also we have contacts within the parish as well. So it's a well-oiled machine as far as
they know what they're doing.
Talking to people about vocations. Back in the day when I was discerning, it really was just Father Steve Davern.
Yeah.
And not much more than that.
And that has been something that in recent years the vocations office has done a great job of setting up these regional teams to help out. I know Father Matt Wheeler, he was in the San Gabriel Valley leading up the team. Is he still there?
He's down at Visitation in Westchester now, and he's in my particular region. Which is Our Lady of the Angels region.
And for those of you who might not know, when we talk about regions, because of Los Angeles is such a large archdiocese covering three counties and millions of Catholics, and we have almost 300 parishes, we have different pastoral regions. And so if you're interested in talking to somebody about a vocation, whether that's a vocation of the priesthood or religious life as a sister or a brother, those are great resources to look up. And so if you're up in the Ventura County area, Santa Barbara County, that'd be the Ventura region. We have the San Fernando region, San Gabriel region, Long Beach, and Our Lady of Angels region itself. So for more information, you can always go to LA Vocations or LACatholics.org to find out more information. And we really encourage anyone who is watching this, whether you're in high school, whether you're in middle school or college and thinking about a vocation, it doesn't hurt to reach out to somebody, right? And all of us have different vocation stories and times we entered formation and times we thought about it. Miguel and I were rather young vocations, but, you know, Father Matt here, Father, you were ordained recently, right?
In 2016. Yeah, I'm what they call an ancient vocation.
An ancient vocation, not just a late vocation.
Yeah. I entered seminary at 45 and was ordained at 51.
So, you know, it's always a possibility, you know, to reach out and ask, talk to those vocation regional vocation directors, or to call into the Archdiocese.
Oh,
Father Masteller going in, and he puts the priest ahead at 8-6. We were tied for just a little bit. Michael Che taking it down court for the... I'm sorry, Michael Lee taking it down court for the seminarians here.
Michael?
Oh, and Father Ramon,
Father Ramon
blocks it.
Father Matt Wheeler.
A year ago, he wouldn't have been doing that.
You know, I spent many days playing against Ramon because we were the two big guys on the court down the street at the Boys and Girls Center, and he's sneaky good. He truly is sneaky good.
Yeah, so tell us a little bit about the maybe tradition of basketball going back to even your time at the seminary. I know now we still are doing it Monday nights. We're up at Santa Clara High School in Oxnard. But during your time, it was at the Boys and Girls Club in Camarillo, right?
Yep. Correct.
We have some beautiful courts down at the seminary. Were those there in your time?
No, they were actually asphalt, very worn asphalt at the time, but they re-poured them and put concrete down there. Which is nice.
It sounds like there might be a story behind that, but I don't know that we have time.
There were a few skin knees, that's for sure.
Yeah, it can be a bit of a dangerous sport. I know Buckets, who is Carlos Tovan, sorry, Buckets, who is the assistant coach for Seminarians this year, isn't on the court because he had a torn ACL earlier in this year. So it does happen, you know. 10 seconds left. Father Mastella trying to get some points in. Oh, and doesn't quite get it.
And
that is the end of the first quarter. And with that, Miguel and I are going to head down onto the court, and we are going to find some people to talk to. Let's see who we might bounce down here. We have just a couple of minutes. And of course, they will be doing some events during the short break here. We're going to see if we can find anyone to talk to. Now, we had Father Matt Wheeler, who we mentioned as one of those regional vocation directors who played the national anthem for us. I'm wondering if we can find him down here. Looks like we might be able to. Yeah. Let's see here. Let's see. How you doing, Father? Now, when you said you were gonna interview, you said, yeah, because I'm not going to be playing that much. What's going on here?
I wasn't playing that much, but I'm feeling it.
Yeah.
I came out here. It's so good to get together. Support seminarians, support vocations. I'm having a blast.
We're going to give you a time to take a breath and see if maybe we can find someone else to talk to.
Thank you.
But thank you for joining us. Thank you. Yeah. Let's see if we can catch someone from Team Seminarian here. Pepe. Let's see here.
Let's see Pepe.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Say hi to the folks at home.
Oh, how you doing? Thank you for watching at home.
Yeah, Pepe, tell us a little bit about what you think of the game so far.
So I think we're starting off a little slow, a little timid. It's our first time playing in front of a crowd. But I think this second quarter and the rest of the game, I'm pretty confident.
Pepe, have you been in yet?
Not yet.
Okay, is that going to be what changes the tide of this game?
I'm a little injured, so we'll see.
Oh, no. Okay, so he's already making excuses for himself here. Oh, no. Anyone you want to say a shout-out to who might be watching the live stream?
Shout-out to...
Or did you just not tell anyone because you didn't want to embarrass yourself?
I don't know who's watching, but I know Alvin's watching back at St. John's. So if you see this, what's up?
You have some parishioners here, too, and
yeah,
our pastor.
Yeah, some right over here. Cheer me on.
Okay, and what is your home parish again?
St. Mary Magdalene, Camarillo.
And what year are you in the seminary?
I'm pre-theology one.
Pre-theology one. He's just starting.
Brand new.
Okay, well, we're going to let you get back in because we don't want to miss any strategy, and we don't want this camera getting too close to finding out what might be going on here. We might have priests watching. Okay, and we're going to make our way back up into the stands here, and we're going to provide some more commentary as we go throughout this game. So keep watching, and we will see you when they start the game up again.
Thanks to Father Matt Murphy up there providing the color commentary for millions, if not billions, watching on the World Wide Web.
Maybe dozens, I don't know.
So just to recap here, at the end of the first quarter, 8-6 with the Priests winning, ahead by 2 points. I don't think they're going to be able to hold that, but we'll see what happens.
This is exactly why I came to join the team this year.
So you could agree with us. Is that what what's going on here?
I predicted a 20-point win by the Priests is what I predicted.
20-point win by the Priests. Okay.
Father, we'll make sure our wishes and desires are rooted in reality. Possible expectations.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
folks watching at home, we're not in the middle of Mass all of a sudden. You don't have to respond. Don't worry.
But you can if you wish.
But he is
because
definitely...
Because you know the response.
Exactly, right? Yeah. Okay, and it's back going here. Tommy Green. Foul, looks like.
See, my favorite part of Tommy Green's game is that he plays basketball the same way he plays football.
And I really I can, well. I, really, really well.
I can really appreciate that, yeah.
It was great. We had some of the Boy Scouts here leading the Pledge of Allegiance. We have them... every once in a while, we'll have them come do tours of the seminary to earn some merit badges. And we were giving a tour a couple weeks ago, and Tommy happened to walk by as I was giving the tour, and I pointed out that my twin brother was there, and they were all really impressed. Now, Tommy and I aren't related, but we're often mistaken as brothers.
Brothers in Christ.
Really, and you know, that is one of the great things about the seminary and about the priesthood is this fraternity that we build up, right? And so, even as the priests, you know, are ordained and they're no longer playing for the seminarian team, you know, it would still be a seminary victory if the priests won, right? Wouldn't you say that, Father Matt?
Well, I'd like to say that Filiberto just had a great steal and passed it off to Lewis Sung for a nice little easy bucket under the basket. Good finish.
There we go. Thomas Lewis struggling a little bit over to Tommy Green. It's and denied.
Tommy Green was the MVP of last year's game.
You think so, he might be able to hold on to that?
Do you think he'll be able to repeat?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Okay. You can't repeat MVP when you lose by 20.
Tommy just stole the ball. So.
He did. Passing it off to Michael.
We're on our way.
Anthony Wynn behind the three-point line, but he does not make it.
Working it in low, we've been working it now. Long range.
Have you seen any strategy from either teams yet, Father Matt?
No, we're at the point where we're just trying to put the ball in the hoop at this point.
Okay. On both teams, is that what you're saying?
The strategy is pretty basic at this point. Pass it if the guy's open, dribble if he's not, and try to get to the basket for a layup.
There we go.
Because it doesn't look like anything from the outside is going down.
Right here in the YouTube comment section, somebody said, wow, Father Matt is a sports announcer now. So I guess you got a fan out there, Father.
Nicker. Nicor P. 000.
I know who it might
That's
be
my,
there.
My newest fan. Thank you, Nicor.
Father Matt. Matt Steller taking a penalty shot there. 11-6. Team Priest. Ooh. Now, not quite 20 points, but priests are ahead by 5. And I am very glad I didn't take you up on that bet. Let me just say that. No, I'm just kidding. There was no bet made. Michael Krogan.
Well, we did not have Father Michael Masteller last year. He is a superb player, so it's good to have him on the team.
Yeah, he helped lead the seminarians to many of their victories.
Mm, he did indeed.
Those many, many victories.
I was not a fan of his game back then.
No. What changed? What might have changed there? Michael Krogan to Christian.
Christian down low, puts it in.
And there we go. 11-8, only down by 3 with 6 minutes 40 seconds left in the second quarter. Father Justin O taking, looking for someone open to Ramon Reyes. Father Ramon Reyes. This is something we brought up last year. As the priests are ordained, and we knew them as seminarians, Father Ramon Reyes was my classmate for 3.5, 4 years. And I do apologize because I will call him Father, or I'll call him Ramon, but he is now, of course, Father Ramon.
He is.
Father, if you can, I can't see the score from where I'm sitting.
It is tied at 11. We've got them right where we want them. Very overconfident.
Oh, you wanted us to score some points.
We meaning you've got the priests right where we want them, right? Is that what you meant?
Well, see, this is why I'm here, fellas, because last year we was just the seminarians, and now there is a we on both sides on this commentating team. So,
that's true. And we had a timeout call. On video here is one of our seminarians. And we're playing a game of what's in the box. Oh, he's trying to figure out what is in the box.
It's chairman of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, also known as the Chancery. And we are here today to play can you spot the fake Jesus? So what we're going to do is approach some random employees of the Archdiocese with a quote, and they have to tell us whether this comes from Jesus himself or if this is fake Jesus. So we will see shortly how many of our employees who work for Jesus really know what Jesus has to say. So let's go and find some employees. So we are here with Douglas Zuniga, who is the coordinator of elementary catechesis for the Archdiocese. And so here is a question for you. From whom does this come? Is this the real Jesus or is this fake Jesus? All you need is love.
Fake Jesus.
Praise God. He knows that Jesus is not the composer of a Beatles song. Hi again. I am here with Jenny Jackson. She is the coordinator of youth ministry events for the Archdiocese. And I have a quote for you. Can you tell us if this comes from the real Jesus or fake Jesus? And the quote is, "Follow me, I will take away all your suffering and make you happy." Real or fake Jesus?
That's real Jesus.
Well, you know, close.
Real fake Jesus.
Real Jesus said something like, "Take up your cross, deny yourself, and follow me."
Fishers of men. I'll make you fishers of men.
Well, she knows a quote from real Jesus. Yes, yes, and he will make you a fisher of men too. Amen. I'm here with Sister Rosalia Mesa, the director of the Office of Religious Education. And a quote for you. You tell us whether this comes from the real Jesus or fake Jesus.
Okay.
Love your neighbor as yourself.
Of course, the real Jesus.
Praise God. Sister knows Jesus and knows what Jesus has to say. Amen.
Amen.
We are now in the development office, and I am here with Wendy Pagoni, who's the associate director of events, and she is going to spot a fake Jesus for us, we hope. And here's the quote. "If the world hates you, remember it hated me first." Is this from the real Jesus or fake Jesus?
I'm going to go with fake Jesus.
Okay. All right. Well, I would advise you to open up your Bible and check out the Gospel of John.
I will do that.
Amen. Good. Good. Always open to learning here at the Archdiocese. Once again, we are here in the development office, and I am joined by Judy Brooks, who is the executive director of the Call to Renew campaign. And so, Judy, I have a question for you. Is this from the real Jesus or fake Jesus? And the quote is, "I have come not to bring peace, but the sword."
I'm going to call that the real deal.
Amen. Judy is the real deal. She got it.
Thank you.
Okay. And Father Parker there going around at the Chancery Office, the ACC, talking to some of the employees there. We want to thank him for that. We actually here in the arena, what are you, gym? What
are, this is a gym.
We're going to make it sound really, really important. An arena, stadium. had a different game going on of Guess What's in the Box, but it looks like you guys had some fun watching that Spot the Fake Jesus quote game there. Back to the game here with a little over 5.5 minutes in the second half, or the first half, second quarter, 11-11. Father Justin O taking it down, and let's see what happens.
Oh, Father O! Father Marino, down on the board!
Father Marino lost it, right, to Tommy Green. You could say that was...
Oh, there's a walk.
Oh, and... Christian,
where do these seminarians think they're going?
I did catch that hand signal. That's traveling, right?
There
I'm
you go.
Learning, guys. Well, fifth game's a charm.
Well, to be fair to you, the signals weren't very crisp last year, so well, you had every right not to know what was going on.
Yes. Yeah.
Father Andrew.
Father Andrew to Father Jihong.
Get in.
Oh.
Michael Krogan with the rebound.
Over to Anthony Wynn, to Christian, keeping it inbounds. Oh, looks like a foul. Did you catch what that foul was? I couldn't quite tell.
A push.
A push. Okay, that was easy to guess, too.
Yeah.
I should have guessed that one. I'll learn. Except this is probably my last year, at least commentating on Team Seminarians.
Oh, battle for the boards. Tommy Green trying to put it back up. Christian Hart.
Yeah, both Miguel and I are getting ready for our diaconate ordination, and this time next year we will be out of the seminary and out into parishes as deacons, God willing.
God willing, yes.
And Archbishop willing. and ourselves through prayer and discernment. But yeah, next year we won't be seminarians. We'll kind of be in between as transitional deacons.
We'll be unbiased next year.
You know, as one of my favorite professors, Father Jack Brennan, would always say, God is willing, just participate.
Well, could you say that like Father Brennan, though?
I'm sorry?
Could you say that like Father Brennan, though?
God is willing, just participate. Close enough.
Yes.
I hope he's not
Father Brennan has been teaching at the seminary. How long now?
Oh, gosh.
Long time. We do have to give a shout out to Father Brennan because he has been forming priests in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles for many, many decades. And is very devoted to us seminarians and to the seminary.
He's a good man.
Very good.
Quick story about him. He spoke of the call of Matthew from Caravaggio in our prayer hall so eloquently, and I fell in love with this painting, another bucket by Father Andrew Chung. And right before I left campus, a half an hour before I left campus for the final time, he gifted me a version of that he had. And I've got that hanging in my office.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. And, of course, that accent there was Irish.
A very bad
Irish.
I might
not have been able to tell. Father. And I wish we had instant replay.
I'm not exactly sure what to call that, but that was a pass inside and a bad tip into the basket by Father Ji-hoon.
As Father Sam said, if you didn't believe in miracles before, one, I'm not sure why you're watching this game, because it is a Catholic game. Two, though, that was proof right there, I think. And if the priests win by 2 points, there was some divine intervention there.
Tommy Green with a bucket from the little side right there.
15-14 Team Priest with less than 3 minutes the first half, and a timeout called by Team Priest. Stopping clock at 2 minutes 54 seconds.
Please come up. Brandon, where you at? Brandon, where you at?
Now Father Peter Salcedo is inviting some crowd down. Father Peter is vocation director. He's been vocation director for now 2 years, assistant vocation director. And you guys weren't classmates, but you were at the seminary for many years.
Peter was a couple years behind me.
And you're able to. So it is great to see this fraternity that we talked about that is built up over the years. Now he's helping to form generations of priests. It's wonderful. Miguel, I see you have your binder open.
All right.
Any fun facts about some of the seminarians you can share with us? I know we've asked for some favorite quotes, some favorite basketball teams. One of them provided a favorite basketball player that when I mentioned the name, Father Krogan. Matt laughed at me because I didn't understand it. Who was that?
So Krogan says that his favorite player is Jimmy Chitwood.
Jimmy Chitwood was the best player on the big screen in the greatest basketball movie of all time, Hoosiers. Jimmy Chitwood was the star of that team.
So. I've seen that movie. That was a good movie.
So
Jimmy Chitwood was the Larry Bird of his time.
Wow.
I'm going to sound really uneducated here. Real or fake?
Actually, it was a story. I don't know if it... I think it might have been a real story. It was about a small town school that played against one of the big town schools in Indiana, which is the home of basketball, essentially.
Okay.
Jimmy Chitwood led the Hoosiers to the state title that year against the powerhouse of Indiana, which was quite improbable.
There we
and
go.
And I believe it was based on a true story, just fictional characters within.
Wonderful. Now, I believe Tommy Green gave one of his favorite quotes. What was that quote he gave us?
His quote was, if you have room for dessert, you didn't try hard enough at dinner. I have mixed feelings about that.
Father, the virtue of temperance and the vice of gluttony are something talked about. Anything to say there?
I really have no comment on that, but I think Miguel has something to say.
Well, I mean, even if there's always room for dessert. I've never been too full for dessert.
Well, I'm biased here. I was a pastry chef before entering the seminary. And I would say, if you don't have room for dessert, yeah, you're doing it wrong because you should have started with dessert.
There you go.
But that probably is not the message we want to send to some of the kids out there watching this. Parents, I apologize. But kids, eat dessert first.
Utah Jazz. And,
oh, Tommy. For all you watching out at St. Dorothy's, Father Ron Clark, very good friend of mine. Yeah, you can hold that one over Tommy's head, and for Christmas, buy him all the desserts he can possibly eat.
Absolutely, because when he comes back to the seminary and he shares them, I will be very great. Except, you know, yeah. Now, I don't know, some of you can see on the live stream right now, up in the corner, we've got some people holding up some larger-than-life masks who is that?
That is Father Justin O.
Father Justin O. What do you have to say about that, Father?
I think one Justin O is enough.
One Justin O is enough. And we do want to thank his parishioners who are here and supporting him. And we invite you guys all to come out again next year. You know, hopefully we'll be doing this again for years to come. We are here in Chatsworth again this year. Last year we were up in Oxnard at Santa Clara High School. We're glad to be back here at Chaminade Preparatory College in Chatsworth. We want to thank them for letting us use these facilities. They're wonderful facilities in the heart of the Simi Valley. And thank you for so many parishioners and just people coming out to support both priests and seminarians alike. It's nice to see.
The score is by Tommy Green. Puts the seminarians one down.
Just under 2 minutes left in the first half.
Apparently the priests don't want to guard. They don't want to play defense this year. Tommy Green puts him on top by 1 point. 17-16 with a free throw coming.
Fired up for the possible 3-point play. Tommy is so Trinitarian.
And it looks like there might have been a foul before that basket.
I'm actually tempted to go home right now, get my uniform, and come back here so we can shut Tommy Green down.
Oh, no. Father Matt, you played how many years in the game?
I just played the first year.
Just
I refereed
first year.
The second year.
Okay.
And then last year I did
now that
not
second
make it.
Year was the year the priests won? Is that
could be.
Yes,
could
it was. Be? It was.
Yeah.
I wonder what happened that year. No, we appreciate your support of this game too.
Well, I did referee with Mary Bissinger's husband Gene, and Gene was probably pulling from the other side, so he balanced it out. It's kind of like I'm balancing this team out.
Yeah, and if Mary and her husband Gene are watching tonight, we want to thank them. Mary Bessinger, of course, is in charge of the HR Human Resources Department at the seminary, has been working there and is a great support to the seminarians as well. So you can tell, you know, this game is really something that pulls together a lot of different people that support vocations.
We have Father Michael Mesteller with a nice drive to the basket and a bucket and a foul. We got one.
18-17 with 52 seconds left in the game, you can see.
And his free throws will look very smooth tonight, so this should go in. There you go.
18-18, all tied up. Michael Krogan tossing to Anthony Windler.
50 seconds on the clock.
Over to Tommy Green.
Oh my goodness.
No foul call.
That was a collision.
This is going to be exciting the last couple of seconds here, maybe. Jose Pacheco, of course, to Anthony Wynn.
I'm quite impressed with the rebounding of the seminarians this year.
No foul called. Tommy gets up. It looks like he might be playing basketball like he plays football there, too.
I'm pretty sure Tommy lost an arm on that last play, and no foul was called. But, hey, no blood, no foul, right?
Grew back pretty quick. We're good. As you said, the football player in Tommy Green is coming out.
I think Father Darren is equally as physical.
Yes, yeah, they are pretty well matched, I would say. Father Masteller, 11 seconds now left in the game. Over to Lewis Sung.
5 seconds left.
And it was out of bounds. 4 seconds left. Michael Krogan is going to take it in here.
Timeout White.
And timeout called by Team Seminarian. 4 seconds left in this first half.
Wow.
And that was an exciting 30 seconds or so.
It really was. I must say, I'm really impressed with the rebounding the Seminarians are doing this year. The year the Seminarians lost, they were not rebounding to save their life. So they've come a long way from however many years ago that was.
That's a good point you make, because rebounding is key, especially on offensive boards. If you can get three shots at the bucket, more than likely that one of those shots is going to go in. So they are very strong on the offensive end. It's a good point, because that is what's saving them right now. Because if they were one and done down here, this score would be completely different. So one thing I noticed in these games is that there isn't a whole lot of contact to screen out. Everyone tries to outjump the other person, which is not the way to do it. So if there's any young people at home watching this basketball game, that is not the way to rebound. You put the body on the person behind you, and you screen them out.
This is a do-as-I-say, not-as-I
not-as-you-do.
Have you considered ever coaching the Priest team?
I just may do that next year, because I've played, I've refereed, now I'm commentating, and next year I just might coach to get all aspects.
That'd be great. And during halftime, we are going to have some different videos for you guys watching different games. So we do encourage you guys to stay watching that. 4 seconds left. Clock back started. Jose Pacheco. And that buzzer ends the first half of the game. Any last comments here before we sign out for the first half? We will be joining you again for the commentary during the second half. But as I said, we have some videos and different things to watch during the halftime show. But any last comments before we sign out?
Yeah, just one quick comment. I said this might not be good basketball, but it's been excellent basketball to this point. This is probably the best pre-seminary game we've had as far as quality of play. So
that's great.
Good. Yeah.
Okay. Well, we encourage you guys to stick around during halftime and keep sending in those comments. We'll start the second half by reading some of those comments, shout outs, and we look forward to checking back in with you. Thank you guys for watching.
And we are here today to play Can You Spot the Fake Jesus? So what we're going to do is approach some random employees of the Archdiocese with a quote, and they have to tell us whether this comes from Jesus himself or if this is fake Jesus. So we will see shortly how many of our employees who work.
Hi, everyone. This is Father Parker Sandoval coming to you from the headquarters of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, also known as the Chancery. And we are here today to play Can You Spot the Fake Jesus? So what we're going to do is approach some random employees of the Archdiocese with a quote, and they have to tell us whether this comes from Jesus himself or if this is fake Jesus. So we will see shortly how many of our employees who work for Jesus really know what Jesus has to say. So let's go and find some employees. So we are here with Douglas Zuniga, who is the coordinator of elementary catechesis for the Archdiocese. And so here is a question for you. From whom does this come? Is this the real Jesus or is this fake Jesus? All you need is love.
Fake Jesus.
Praise God. He knows that Jesus is not the composer of a Beatles song. Hi again. I am here with Jenny Jackson. She is the coordinator of youth ministry events for the Archdiocese. And I have a quote for you. Can you tell us if this comes from the real Jesus or fake Jesus? And the quote is, "Follow me, I will take away all your suffering and make you happy." Real or fake Jesus?
that's a real Jesus.
Well, you know, close.
Real fake Jesus.
Real Jesus said something like, take up your cross, deny yourself, and follow me.
Fishers of men. I'll make you fishers of men.
Well, she knows a quote from real Jesus. Yes, yes, and he will make you a fisher of men too. Amen. I'm here with Sister Rosalia Mesa, the Director of the Office of Religious Education. And a quote for you, you tell us whether this comes from the real Jesus or fake Jesus. Love your neighbor as yourself.
Of course, the real Jesus.
Praise God. Sister knows Jesus and knows what Jesus has to say. Amen.
Amen.
We are now in the development office, and I am here with Wendy Pagoni, who's the Associate Director of Events, and she is going to spot a fake Jesus for us, we hope. And here's the quote. If the world hates you, remember it hated me first. Is this from the real Jesus or fake Jesus?
I'm going to go with fake Jesus.
Okay. All right. Well, I would advise you to open up your Bible and check out the Gospel of John.
I will do that.
Amen. Good. Good. Always open to learning here at the Archdiocese. Once again, we are here in the development office, and I am joined by Judy Brooks, who is the executive director of the Call to Renew campaign. And so, Judy, I have a question for you. Is this from the real Jesus or fake Jesus? And the quote is, I have come not to bring peace, but the sword.
I'm going to call that the real deal.
Amen. Judy is the real deal. She got it.
Thank you.
Good for you. I'm here with Sister Angelica Orozco, and the question for you is, does this come from the real Jesus, or is this a fake Jesus? Okay. And the quote is, give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free.
That's fake.
Amen. That is fake. That is from the Statue of Liberty, not from the Lord, which means Sister knows him. We are now in the Vicar for Clergy office, and I am here with Luz Higuera, and she is going to tell us whether this quote comes from the real Jesus or a fake Jesus. And the quote is, no servant is greater than his master. Real or fake Jesus?
Fake Jesus.
Open up the Gospel of John, and you'll find that that's a real Jesus quote. But
is it really?
It is. He means that none of his disciples are greater than him. He is the greatest. He is the master.
That's true. That's very true.
Amen. Jesus is the master. He's in charge. Yes, she gets absolutely. It. Once again, here in the Vicar for Clergy office, this time with Monica Burgos, who is the administrative assistant here, and she's going to be able to tell us whether this quote comes from the real Jesus or a fake. So, Monica, here's the quote. A dead thing can go with the stream, but only a living thing can go against it. Real or fake Jesus?
Let me think about that. I want to say, oh my goodness, real Jesus?
Okay. Well, I don't know who said that quote, but it's definitely not Jesus. But that's a good try. You love Jesus, right?
Yes, I do.
Praise God. She loves Jesus anyway.
Love it. I love it. I love it. Come on out. Come on out. Here we go. Facing me. You're all facing me. All right. There we go. Move down a little bit more. Wow. All right. So for those of you who stand, 50-50 raffle ends at halftime. So we have seminarians selling the raffle tickets. See them if you want the 50-50, it ends at halftime. All right. Brother, sister, boys and girls, are you ready? Yeah. All right, so my name is Father Mike, and I'm going to be leading you in this wonderful game of Simon Says. It's pretty much pretty simple. I think you all know how to play Simon Says. If I say Simon Says and I say something, you have to do it. If I don't say anything and I tell you to do something, then
you're out, all right? Any type of flinching means that you are automatically out, all right? So any type of flinching, even a little bit, you are going to be called out. Got it? All right, here we go. So Simon says, game on. Are you ready? All right, here we go. Raise your hand. You're out, you're out, you're out, you're out, you're out, you're out, you're out. Raise your hand. You are out. Come on. You guys are out. Sorry, you're out. You raise your hand. I didn't say Simon Says. You're out. Let's go. Move. This is going to be very quick. All right. Oh, wait. You know what? You know what? I forgot. We got to lead in prayer. Okay? So in the name of the Father and the Son. If you did sign the cross, you are out. If you made the sign of the cross, you are out. All right. Here we go. Here we go. All right. Here we go. Simon Says, put your hands up. Simon Says, put your hands down. Simon Says, put your hands up. Put your hands down. All right. You're out. All right. Simon Says, wiggle your hands in the air like you just don't care. Right? Simon Says, hands down. Simon Says, hands up. Simon Says, hands down. Simon Says, hands up, hands down. You're out. You're out. All right. Come on. Move, move down, move down, move down, move down, move down, move down. You're out. You're out. You're out. You're out. You're out. You're out. Right? All right. Simon Says, move on down. Simon Says, move on down. Simon Says, move on down, move on down, move on down. Stop. Oh, you're out. All right, Simon Says, come on, closer, closer together, closer together. Come all the way closer together, here we go, here we go, all right. Here we go, Simon Says, hop on one foot. Simon Says, hop on one foot, Simon Says, hop on one foot. Simon Says, put your hands down. Simon Says, stop. All right, you guys ready for this? You doing okay? All right, here we go. So my name's Father Mike, what's your name? What's your name? You guys want to know his name? What's your name? No, what's your name? Raymond, you're out, Raymond, sorry. All right. Here we go. All right. Simon Says, turn around. Simon Says, turn around again. All right. Simon Says, touch your head. All right, Simon Says, touch your stomach. Touch your head. Oh, sorry, girl. You're out. It's okay. It's okay. You did good job. Good job. Good job. All right. Here we go. Simon Says, hands up. Simon Says, hands down. Simon Says, hands up. Simon Says, hands down. Hands up. And oh man, ooh! All right, Simon Says, face one another. Face one another. Here we go. All right, Simon Says, get a little closer. All right, Simon Says, stop. All right, Simon Says, give each other a mean look, a nice mean look. All right, good. Here we go. Simon Says, hands up. Simon Says, hands down. Simon Says, hands up. Simon Says, touch your toes. Stand up. All right, very good. Simon Says, stand up. All right, face me. Face me. Oh, you did it first! You blitzed! Here's our winner! Awesome! Good job! Alright, we got a prize for you. Awesome, come that way, we got a prize for you. Good job. And that, my friends, is Simon Says.
Maria. Alright, my friends. And for our final halftime activity, I want to invite Corbin Wong to please come join us. Corbin, where are you at? Let's give a big, big shout out for him. Let's hear it. How are you, Corbin? Good, good. Where are you from?
Santa Clarita.
Face that way so everybody can see you. Right here, right there, there's a camera. Everybody's watching. There's about 5,000 people watching right now. Maybe not that many, but a good amount. How old are you, Corbin?
I'm 22.
22 years old. What are you doing? Are you going to school? Are you working?
Graduated. I'm working as an accountant.
Where did you graduate from?
Cal State Northridge.
Cal State Northridge. Very nice. What was your degree?
Bachelor's degree?
Yeah.
Financial analysis.
Finance. Very good. Well, let's give it up for Corbin. Corbin is going to try to make a half-court shot. We're going to give him one practice shot. All right? So let's give it up for Corbin. This is a practice shot. This is a practice shot. All right, here's the real deal. Here's the real deal. Let's give a big round of applause for Corbin. Ah! Good try, man. Grab some concessions. We have 50-50.
Players can come back onto the court now. get their halftime warm-ups to get the blood pumping again for the second half. 3 minutes left to buy 50-50 raffle tickets. 3 minutes to buy 50-50 raffle tickets.
Hello, everyone. My name is Kuo Kuo. I'm an intern at Holy Trinity Paris. I'm here to play the game, Guess What's in the Box. Is it a sock?
Yeah.
Easy. I think candy, right? It's coffee. Coffee bean. Easy.
Hi, my name is Paul Collins. I'm doing my internship year here at Resurrection Parish in Boyle Heights. And I guess we're going to play Guess What's in the Box.
Let's see here. I think we got Tostitos. Well, tortilla chips here. No, it's not tortilla chips. Potato chips? Pringles. Ah, my favorite.
See what we got here.
Another bowl. Oh, is that like menudo? Oh, what the? Canned soup? Spaghetti? That's some kind of pasta. Oh my gosh, cold pasta. I don't know, macaroni and cheese? Chicken soup? It is chicken soup? Oh, gross, cold chicken soup. This. Oh, we got some kind of action figure. Let's see. Now we got some teeth there, some claws. I'm thinking this got to be like a velociraptor or a Tyrannosaurus Rex. It's got the little arms. Not a T-Rex? It's got to be. All right. T-Rex.
Hi, everyone. My name is Christian Marchetto. I'm a seminarian for the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. I am currently on internship at St. John Vianney, and today I'm going to be playing Guess What's in the Box.
A big enough arm. Is it like thingies? Are these old people candy? Okay, like I don't know if I can say that. I don't know what this is. Oh, they're gummy worms! Oh.
These ones are smaller. Is it like a type of cereal? No. They feel like peanuts. I'm gonna lock it in. Peanuts. No?
Oh, they're coffee beans!
Is this like an action figure? Is this something holy? Oh, okay. No, I know what this is. Is this like a dinosaur? It's a T-Rex.
Packed crowd here in Chatsworth, California. God's country.
Okay, welcome back. Before we start gameplay here in the second half, we want to remind everybody the score is 18-18, all tied up. Could we say that first half didn't count? No, no, they played hard. Before they start here, any comments we want to
Yeah, so there's on the YouTube live chat, there's a Miguel Cabrera saying, "Let's go, Seminarians." Wait, that was
Let's
me.
Let's go. That Miguel, he's a smart guy.
El Krogan saying, "Go, Mikey, number 13. And then later on, she also said, "You're doing great, Mikey. Love you, Mom." So I'm assuming that's Michael's mom. Sending her best wishes to Michael Krogan. We also have a shout-out here for the parishioners at St. Gertrude. Let's go, Father Justin, representing St. Gertrude.
Right, start of the third quarter. All tied
that's
up
great.
We also saying some people are missing Carlos Buckets Tobone because he's not playing this year. But yes, hopefully he'll be back in the future.
That's great. Okay.
It's no longer tied up now. The priest take a 2-point lead with that jumper from Father Michael Massello.
Michael Krogan, too hard.
Krogan trying Tommy Green rebound, but it looks like there's a, was that a foul?
They are certainly letting him play. That is a foul, and two shots for Tommy Green.
Tommy Green. Let's see how he takes those. Maybe a Hail Mary pass or something.
I think that's a different sport, Stephen.
I know that, but we were addressing he plays like a, you know, footballer, and so, you know, he'll make a home run. I get it. Let's go.
Oh. We were, just a few minutes ago, we were threatened by Team Green, who is here in person, that we had to give a shout-out to Team Green. So
Team Green
is here rooting for Big Bad Tommy Green.
Okay, I see. Oh, Team Green as in Tommy Green. I see. Okay.
I don't know that we were threatened, but he did ask.
He did. Yeah, but Father Justin O taking it up. Oh,
nice save.
By himself.
Oh, off the shoulder.
Tommy Green to Michael.
Tommy Green taking it hard.
Oh! We do have to say, it could have been Michael Krogan's family. It also could have been Michael...
But it looked good, Tommy.
Michael Lee.
Lee's family as well.
The username was Al Krogan.
It could have still been, you know. Maybe they wanted to disown Krogan and adopt Michael Lee into the family. I don't know.
As Chick Hearn would say, the mustard is off the hot dog with that pass. A little bit too tricky for their own good.
Oh, clears out.
Wei Feng or Joseph Tong.
Father Michael Nassau with the rebound.
Skies for the rebound.
Ramon. Father Ramon
Tommy Green taking
into the hands
down.
Of Tommy Green. To Michael Krogan, to Joseph Tong, Wei Feng, to Tommy Green, to Krogan, to Michael Lee. Pacheco and Krogan fighting over rebound, not realizing for a second they're on the same team.
The snack door only has drinks to sell now. Food sales have ended.
As I said earlier, the rebounding for the Priests has been less than spectacular. You cannot rebound from underneath the basket. You can only get the ball that goes through the bucket. Not a good place for rebounding.
I'm going to have to trust you on that one. I really am. Jose Pacheco, first-year theology there. Making one of the free throws, bringing it up 19-20 with the Priests. And the lead by 1 point. Let's see what happens. And the Priests are going to hold on to the lead for just a little longer.
Rebound, but off his foot. Team Priests bring up the ball off the court.
Father Masteller to Father Justin O.
St. Gertrude in Bill Gardens.
3-point shot.
In and out again, too. Fresh in the words as Michael Krogan.
Looked like that might have been.
That is a foul. That's a pushing foul from the back. By Father Ramon.
Michael Lee.
Down below.
You have a two-shot foul coming up.
That's going to be Michael Lee taking those free throws here. Another chance for the Seminarians to tie the game, get ahead if they can.
Michael Lee shares the same first name as Michael Jordan.
Ah. I know him, a basketball player.
I have no idea why that fact makes any difference in this game, but it really doesn't.
There you go.
It wasn't even worth saying. They did.
You know, sometimes you just got to say something, I suppose. You know, folks, on Monday, Father Matt Murphy came out to the seminary and drove all the way from his parish in Malibu
all the way.
Yeah, on a Monday to have a bit of a strategy session with Miguel and I here on commentary. And we did meet for about 2.5 hours. And I think we talked on strategy for about negative 2 minutes of that. And it's showing. So, yes, Michael Lee sharing a first name with Michael Jordan.
Father Ji-hoon with a nice little jumper from the baseline for 2 points.
And Priest ahead by 3 points.
Priest take an insurmountable 3-point lead.
Back up to Jose Pacheco.
An insurmountable 3-point lead.
Jose, serving the court.
keep sending in those comments on our different live streams here, and Miguel will chime in occasionally with some of them.
Krogan taking it hard. Off the glass.
Wow. Oh, Father Ramon getting the rebound there. Out to Father Justin O. Down to Father Filiberto.
Father Philly.
Gets his own rebound. Wei Fang playing a little volleyball there.
Father Philly setting with it up. Some style points there.
So we've seen football, we've seen soccer, we've seen volleyball in this game so far.
Everything but basketball. That's an easy two for Father Andrew Chung.
Father Andrew Chung.
St. Pancratius.
Yep, it's St. Pancratius. Let's give a shout out to anyone from St. Pancratius that either is watching or...
Today's Michael Jordan's birthday.
Well, get that.
There you go.
Look at that.
He's 60 years old today.
60 years old.
He's with us in spirit.
There we go.
I think that's why you said his name earlier.
Matt, you just never know.
You guys having fun?
Oh, we're having a great time. Father Sam is asking us if we're having fun up here. Father Sam, of course, giving commentary in the gym here. And he's given some shout outs to all of you guys watching on the live stream.
Off a load of a 3-point play.
5 minutes.
Nice little and one from Jose Pacheco, and a fist pump by my fellow commentator Miguel Cabrera. I didn't know you could be biased on this panel, but that's all's fair in love and war, right?
And basketball.
And basketball.
And if we ever see it, we'll...
Love and basketball is another movie.
We'll say that's true.
We got a shout-out here, rooting for Tommy Green from St. Dorothy Glendora. Nancy...
and Tommy Green catching the rebound there.
You also have Carol Wesley.
By Tommy Green.
You also have Carol Westlake rooting for Team Seminarians. Go Michael, St. Kateri Parish.
Krogan. That is Michael Krogan.
Krogan.
And there is Michael Krogan. You know, we mentioned Tommy Green. Tommy Green makes the basket. We mentioned Michael Krogan. He gets the rebound. Let's mention Michael Lee and see what happens here.
Tommy Green, take a step.
Oh. Third time was not lucky there.
We have a comment here that just says better than the NBA. I don't know if they mean the game or the commentary.
It's 23-24.
Based on what we've seen, I'm sure it's the commentary.
Not that we're biased.
But based on what I've heard, it might be the game.
And maybe they're just not watching and referring to something else entirely. But thank you for that.
It sure doesn't say better there. Switch to the NBA.
Oh, he gets one.
Tommy gets the roll.
Seminarians ahead now. Let's see if they can hold on to this insurmountable lead, as you referred to it shortly.
Father Chong.
Yeah, we have no rebounding on the priest side.
No,
I think we've given up on rebounding.
Tenacious D.
We got some. Tenacious
G, a reference to Jack Black, and the priests are wearing black.
There we go. Father Andrew was doing some defense there.
Michael Lee.
Tommy Green. Up to Tommy Green. Now, that was a little dramatic by Father Justin O there. The jump catch, you know. Was that necessary or just some good showmanship?
Well, when you're rebounding as poorly as the priests are right now, any emphasis on the rebound is a welcome sight.
Sometimes style points might just put you ahead. Is that what you're saying?
Trying to fire up the team.
There we go. Well, it made for some entertaining sports, that's for sure. Or entertaining something.
Tommy Green
keeping that lead ahead.
3-point insurmountable lead.
Insurmountable. It's a great word. Word of the day calendar right there. Word of the day. Yeah.
Player coach Muasong barking out the instructions. Oh!
And for a church that has some incredible words, insurmountable to be the word of the day is quite fascinating.
Yes.
I mean, we have transubstantiation, hyperstatic union, but now we have insurmountable.
And insurmountable. Yep.
Thank you, Peyton Manning.
I don't know what to add to that. Thank you for that.
Father Darren. Oh, holy shit.
Father Darren. Michael Krogan.
Tommy Green.
To Tommy Green.
Wow, Tommy Green is just lighting it up. He might just get that MVP again.
I was just going to bring that up. Yeah.
You know, all of that Monday night basketball playing, you know, is really paying off.
Yeah. It is easy to win MVP when you're on the winning team. Is that what you're saying, Father?
I think I might have to leave you guys in the fourth quarter to go coach the Priest team.
that might be necessary.
Wow.
You know, I'm not quite sure what Coach Reichardt said to the Seminarians at the halftime. It might have been something about failing them, keeping them from ordination, but it seems to have lit a fire under them.
Might be on the line here.
They might just be. No, that's not fair. Dr. Reichardt is a great professor, and she would never, ever hold that above them. Right.
It's a giveaway. Who's the challenge? Whoever cheers the loudest, our Seminarians will give them a pizza.
And for those of you at home who are having a difficult time hearing us, we'll explain why after this.
I was wondering if I can turn my mic off so that I can shout for the pizza.
Just leave it on. Let's see what happens. Our sound guy is waving at us. No, don't do that. No. Okay, let's see what happens. Oh, we missed it. We missed it. Oh. Woo! It's one more. They're giving out free pizza in the stands. Another reason to come next year.
Carol Westlake says she loves the laughter from the crew coverage. Go, Father Matt.
Shout out to Carol Westlake, good friend from St. Kateri.
And we're getting a shout out to the live stream crew from Father Sam, who's doing the in-house commentary for us. I'm not sure if you can hear him over our mics or not, but giving a shout out to all of you guys at home watching. So thank you for joining us this evening. We know you may have, I don't want to use the word better things to do on a Friday night. You may have things to do, though. And they may be better in degree. And so we appreciate you taking time to watch this and joining us, hopefully having some laughs. You know, we like to make jokes. We're pretty lighthearted up here. But again, I just keep coming back to it. It really speaks to the fraternity that we find in our vocation. Because that's something brothers do, right? You know, kind of rib each other a little bit. But in the end, we are there to support each other. And I think we'll see that no matter who wins tonight. You're going to see both these teams coming together to appreciate each other, congratulate each other.
Exactly. No, this is definitely a night of fraternity. Doesn't mean we don't want to win. Tommy Green again. Holy
Tommy Green, 33-24. Now, we said 1 point was insurmountable. 3 points was insurmountable. What is 9 points?
9 points is, like I told you, we're getting you overconfident right now for a fourth quarter.
There we go. So now you have to get 29 points ahead for that 20-point win.
Oh, easy.
Easy. Okay. Easy. Okay. Yeah. Let's see what happens.
I think being ahead by 9 points, that's just a big insurmountable times three.
Well, yeah. The perfection of insurmountable.
Well, the good news is, in a half a minute, you two are going to leave this post and go down to interview somebody, so I get to speak all by myself for a whole minute.
And I'm going to ask our sound guys, maybe cut that out. No. That is true. We will not be able to hear you. And I'm a little worried.
Maybe only one of us should go, and then the other one stays and watches Father Matt.
Father Darren with a free throw.
Father making a free throw here. 33-26. Okay, catching up. Slow and steady wins the race. You have 11 and a half minutes.
Got to move your feet on defense there, fellas. Tommy Green is moving at will. They need to put a body on him and keep him stationary.
That's just good advice.
I think I may be coaching the fourth quarter.
That is just good advice, I think. when it comes to Tommy Green. Keep an eye on him. Yeah.
Tommy Green with the making the first of a front of a two-shot foul. And the second goes in as well.
Still looking for a first dunk of the night by a player that's not a kid. Andrew Chung
with a bucket and one. 35-28. Seminarians are leading. 56 seconds left in the third quarter.
35-28. Down by a touchdown again.
According to Father Sam, we are scoring in touchdowns now. The way Tommy Green plays, I can see why. It's all about football. No, I just kid. He is a good player. And the free throw goes in.
Reese looking for a stop before the end of the quarter.
Into Tommy Green, over to Jose Pacheco, down low, loses the ball, regains it, throws a hook shot. Off the crease, out of bounds, Seminarian ball on the baseline. I think we truly have transitioned to football. Father Darren with a foul on Tommy Green, and Tommy Green goes to the line to shoot a bonus foul. 1+1. Green with a first to the front end of it, one-on-one. Gets his second shot here.
Back up by seven. 8 seconds to go.
Tommy Green is a one-man wrecking crew right now. They've got to find a way to shut him down. I think I might have to shoot up. Short.
Aaron stripped three.
Foul is on Christian to end the third quarter. And we are going over to an interview.
Okay, and I'm joined here by the winner of our Simon Says. This is Jack. He is a parishioner over at St. Kateri. Jack, how was it to win Simon Says?
It was nice. I'm really glad I won those $25 from Amazon.
$25 to Amazon. Was it hard? Or do you usually do what you're told anyways?
I usually do what I'm told anyways.
There we go. And what church do you go to?
St. Kateri.
St. Kateri. And what grade are you in?
Second grade.
Second grade. Awesome. And what do you want to be when you grow up?
Priest.
A priest. That's awesome. Who's your priest over at St. Kateri?
Father Jihoon,
are you voting for Team Seminarian or Team Priest?
Team Priest.
Oh, my goodness. He wants to be a Seminarian.
No, I want to be a
priest. Oh, you want to be a priest. That's good. All of us in the seminary, we don't want to be in the seminary for too long. We want to be priests. Yeah. Okay. Well, we're going to keep you in our prayers and keep in touch and say hi to your dad real quick. Who's your dad back here?
Dick.
That's awesome. Okay, well, thank you. Thank you guys for coming out. Thank you for playing Simon Says. And get something fun with that Amazon gift card, okay? Anyone you want to say hi to?
Hi, Father Jihoon.
Hi, Father Jihoon. Go Father Jihoon, right?
Right.
There we go. Okay, what about Michael, the seminarian? What about him? Oh, no.
I'm voting for priest because when seminarian Michael becomes a priest, I'll vote for him, too.
There we go. That's good. Okay, well, thank you for joining us. You guys have a great rest of the night, okay?
Okay, thank you.
That was Jack, the winner of our Simon Says game. We want to thank everyone for coming out who's playing with us. We were going to try to get a hold of Buckets, a fan favorite, but I don't see him around.
Yeah, I don't see him either.
Yeah. So we are... Here we go. Buckets here. We're going to have an exclusive interview with him right now. Buckets,
everybody,
say hi to your fans.
Everybody, it's Buckets here. So good to be here with you, even though I can't play this year, but it's great to be an assistant coach. So
you have a lot of fans out there that are asking, you know, what's going on? How come you're not on the field? On the court.
I think we wanted to give the priest a chance. So I injured my knee playing basketball on October 31st. So I tore my ACL and my meniscus, so I'm not able to play. But thankfully, I can walk and I can coach a little bit. So that's good.
Buckets, of course, sponsored next year, and his team playing by Home Depot. We're going to have those orange buckets out here for us.
There we go.
Maybe have some drums going on those. That'd be a fun halftime game. I don't know. We'll think of something, though, because Buckets, the fans love you.
Thanks so much, everybody. Praying for you. Thank you.
Okay. And we're going to throw it back to Father Matt up for the commentary here. Folks, we're have an announcement from Father Pedro Salcedo to fill our intermission here, and we're going to start this fourth quarter with Michael Krogan taking it in for the Seminarian at half court. Tommy Green with 21 points in this game so far, so we've got to let him find a way to shut him down as the Priest team enters this fourth quarter down by 7 points. A foul by Father Justin O in the corner.
There's a fan, Chairman Lau is saying that you can coach from up on the stands.
Chairman Lau hasn't been to a basketball game in a long time, apparently. Otherwise, I'd be blowing everyone's ear out trying to coach from this position. But thanks, Nick. Appreciate it, buddy. Well, look at that. The Priest got a rebound. We're off to a good start in the fourth quarter, Miguel.
Let's see if it's enough to change the game.
Here in this fourth quarter, 36-29.
Very deliberate offense going on here by the Priest, and a block shot by Krogan.
One Michael on another. Michael Krogan.
I thought for a second that was going to go to Tommy Green, but Michael Lee kind of came out of nowhere.
Wow.
Little dipsy doo through the lane for 2 points. And that insurmountable lead just keeps getting larger and larger here. You know, let's not keep going back to that word. Let's put that one to rest. I think that might be a good idea. There. Still unsure why players tap their chest saying it's my fault when we know it's their fault. Never did understand that in basketball.
Father Justin Owen ball.
3-point attempt by Father Andrew Chung goes in. And we are back in the game.
There we go.
32-38.
Oh, I must say that three looked pretty surmountable.
Whiffing, trying to get it. Tommy Green out to Whiffing. Back to Tommy Green. There's some good rebound, right? Well, there was a tackle down low, too. You know, in cooking, we call that fusion. Fusion. You've got foods of different cultures coming together. Here we've got tactics of different sports coming together. And we could call it foosball or something. I don't know. It does not bode well for people to leave here healthy if we keep playing like this.
No.
There we go. Another Mass Seller taking it down court quickly there.
Oh, look too much! And that was it, too!
Priest getting some good looks, but not finishing. A timeout called by Team Seminarian here.
We want to direct your attention to our screen level here.
Miguel, did we ever get clarification on what was NBA level? Was it the play or was it the commentary?
You know, they never said. So I think that's up for interpretation.
this year.
And if we were to go with the hermeneutic of continuity, just you know how the years gone in the past, I want to say it's the commentary. I think we can fairly say that they're talking about the commentary. I've listened to NBA commentary and it's not as entertaining.
We're literally Chick Hearn level esque. Okay, maybe not, but we're trying our best.
But there is somebody here that says that Tommy Green is greater than LeBron James.
I do have to say, if anyone were to get poached by professionals, I don't know that it would be the people on the court. As much as I love them. But you know, I could see it. I could see it up here. You know? Oh no, they come to us. Oh.
Well, not we're including you.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. And in fact, I think we're just going to offer commentary for a lot of diocesan events from now on. The chrism masses, the ordinations, it's going to be great.
Well, how's that going to work for us when we get ordained?
We can make it work. We'll make
from the
work.
Altar, we can offer commentary.
From the altar.
It may disturb, yes, Archbishop a little bit.
Yes.
It may it be a little disconcerting for everyone celebrating the Mass.
I think maybe we'll just keep the liturgies a little reverent, and we can comment the other thing.
I think that's a really, really good idea.
Well, formation works, Father.
Spoils
for, you know, I've learned a thing or two in seminary.
This is fruity. It has the texture of an apple, which... But it might be
and it looks like both teams trying to come up with a strategy for the last 7 minutes of the game. I was going to say 7-11 minutes of the game, but we're not sponsored by them either. We approached them like Home Depot, but for some reason, they didn't want their name attached to this. I'm not sure.
They don't sell buckets.
That is the problem.
I did notice you had an interview with Carlos Buckets.
We did. And we talked about that, Home Depot. We're going to reach out to them next year, find out maybe if we can get some halftime drumming on Buckets, something going on, a bucket race maybe, both feet in a bucket. We'll see what happens.
That would be brilliant.
But yeah, comment on any games that you might want to see with Buckets, whether the person or the object, in these last 7 minutes, and maybe we'll do that next year. We'll see. I don't know.
We do have Mike Alvarez Sr. is saying, hello, Father Matt. We miss you at St. Kateri.
Go Raiders. That's what I always say to Mike Alvarez. We're Raider fans. So go Raiders.
I see.
There's a lot of Raider fans in my family. I'm from Oxnard, and there are a lot of Raider fans in the city of Oxnard.
You have a very classy family, sir.
It's a very classy city.
Yes.
There you go. Because I want to be ordained for LA, I'll keep my mouth quiet.
Fourth quarter.
But other NorCal teams, go. Yeah, there we go.
Well, here we are right at the beginning of this fourth quarter, and we have a 6-point game, which should be evaporating very quickly.
You mean it becomes a 7-point game?
Evaporating means when it shrinks. So that might not be the word you're looking for there. Expanding. Yeah.
That's not the word I was looking for.
Okay, well, we'll see what happens. You know, yeah, tomato, tomato. That doesn't apply to this situation, but we'll see what happens. Yeah. And we got some of our seminarians running through the stadium here, Paul Maxey and Vinny. I don't remember Vinny's last name, unfortunately. But trying to get the crowd behind the winning team here, Team Seminarian. It didn't last very long. I don't know what happened. They ran once, and now it's
two steal by the Seminarians. We just want to get this down to... Oh, no.
Christian trying to get some action there.
6:44 to go.
Comes down with a rebound and gets the foul, going to the line to shoot two. Father Darren with possibly his 15th foul. I have no idea if they're keeping track of Bristol fouls, but I've seen a lot from him.
Yep.
Oh.
Christian, not quite making that one, but I have faith in him. See what happens. And I think the coach for Team Priest might have heard you there. Pulled Father Darren out. Father Ramon Ray is coming in for him.
Do we have a coach?
No.
Is Father Lewis Sung the coach?
I want to say he normally does take charge.
Last year you claimed it was the Holy Spirit, but the Holy Spirit would not see us lose. So that
could not the Holy Spirit was on the seminarian team.
There we go. Father Ramon Reyes out to Father Masteller. Masteller.
There's a block, uncalled block. Priest working it around the outside. Andrew Chung with a nice drive, but he needs to finish. Masteller with a steal and a bucket. 4-point lead, 5-point lead.
5.5 for the Seminarians here with 6 minutes, 8 seconds left in this final quarter.
There's a long three attempt off the side of the rim.
I don't know if Coach Libby liked that one.
We have a bucket and an and-one situation.
3 points that evaporated lead, as I said earlier. Someone said, let's
That's because the Seminarians have the priest right where they want him.
Yeah. We
threw insurmountable out and put
evaporating right back in. Yep. We had some chance in the crowd here of Let's Go Priests.
Very wise chance.
They were not led by you. Slightly surprised there.
39-37 after that made free throw.
Let's see what happens. 5 minutes, 30 seconds left.
And Father Ramon is on Tommy Green. He's going to shut him down like he used to shut me down in the Monday night games.
Let's see what happens here.
Or maybe not.
That's what I like to see. That's what I like to see.
That's not the same defense he used to use on me. Another three-pointer from Father Andrew Chung. This is
Michael Krogan, rebound for Father tallest, I think, on Team Seminarian.
Anthony. Oh, collision on the court.
Tommy Green, yes!
Tommy Green with a putback.
That lead's coming back.
43-37 with a timeout on Team Priest.
For all you youngsters out there, just want to remind you, when you play the game of basketball, you have to do the things that you don't really want to do, like rebound and play defense. And that's what's hurting the Priests right now, is the fact that they don't want to, they just want to take shots at the other end. They all want to be Michael Jordan. Nobody wants to be Dennis Rodman.
Oh, we got a wave going now.
Absolutely.
We got a wave on the far sideline.
I know you wouldn't lie to me, Father. And I'm going to say both of those are real people too, right?
Those are.
Okay.
They are not Jimmy Chitwood.
I'm 2 for 2. Well, 3 for 3. There we go. And we got the wave going on this side.
Let's see. Tonight.
And it's going all the way around this stadium here.
What an amazing crowd tonight.
This is a really good-sized crowd, as Father Sam notes right now, and very active. So it's great to see this participation here.
It is, and we hope that all of you at home are participating in the wave. If you're watching it alone, just one hand at a time works. If there's a couple of you, you know, just go along the couch. It works. Be creative is what I'm saying, you know. And the tide's going out a little bit.
And Paul and Vinny down at the end of the court looking very proud that they started the wave, but I need to remind them that pride is the root of all sin. So.
Oh, they'll be getting a letter, is that what you're saying?
I won't comment that the four people who won the pieces didn't offer the color commentator a piece, but that's okay, I'm not bitter. I'm fasting tonight, I'm getting ready for Lent, don't worry, I'm not bitter.
Michael Krogan with a two-pointer there. That lead, it just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
At 45-37.
I think insurmountable is about to come back, that word. Christian with the rebound.
No control. Get the rebound. There you go.
But Father Masteller there for the rebound. Out to Father Ji.
Father Ji-hoon, the 2 points under the basket.
The crowd goes wild. Again, St. Kateri.
I mean, that was kind of an easy one. He should have made that one. I'm just kidding.
Can we hope for overtime, which we didn't get in the Super Bowl?
Let's see. 45-39, 3 minutes, 35 seconds left.
Oh, Michael Cronin. Steal.
I have to say shout out to Cinque Terre. They're watching at home and they're here in person. They've got well represented. They've got Father Vaughn is in the crowd, Father Jihoon on the court, myself here commentating, and two seminarians here. We've got Michael and Manny are here.
Emmanuel, and we also have Stephen, who's at
and
Queen
Stephen,
of Angels.
I'm sorry, Stephen. Yep. I apologize.
The other Stephen, not me. Other Stephen.
Young Stephen.
Young Stephen, if you will. Yep. And Father Darren coming back in with 3 minutes left. Might expand the game a little.
Down six. 7 a.m. ball out of the side. Tommy Green, our high score that I.
You know, you were mentioning how great it is such an active, large crowd here. But those of you guys at different parishes who are watching from home, again, the more people we get here, the larger stadium arena we have to keep finding, Jim, you know. It would be great to move this to one of the university campuses or something, you know. Could you imagine if we could sell out large place?
I tell you what, being a former referee, I like when places are packed. So let's stay here and let's just add more people to the crowd.
There we go. I like that.
Tommy Green is essentially unstoppable. He scores two more points. I believe he has 27 on the night, which is crazy.
Impressive.
My classmate.
Andrew Chung with a free throw. Front end of a two-shot foul.
About 2 minutes, 40 seconds left.
Father Andrew,
that will be the priest ball.
And
nice try to save it.
Taking a step up there, stepping up for the team to the stadium.
Glad no one got hurt there.
Nobody was hurt.
He wanted a piece of pizza.
I believe a chair was hurt in that dive. But
yeah.
No people were hurt. Could have been worse.
And that's right. There were people sitting right on the each side of that.
Might be the second miracle of the night. That
these referees are certainly letting them play.
Christian with the rebound.
Father Jihoon couldn't make it in.
So we have 2 minutes left. 47-40 game. Seminarians leading.
Number seven, Jose Pacheco to Tommy Green. And it looks like Priests are going to take it in.
Got a sub. Michael Krogan back in.
We have a running clock for some reason, so we need to conserve time here.
Yep. And Anthony Wynn stepping out after that dramatic dive into the stands. And Michael Krogan coming in for him. This might come to a Kateri against Kateri sort of game.
Drive to the basket and 2 points from Andrew Chung. Puts the Priest down by five with a little over 1 minute left.
Minute 10 left.
I think they're going to have to foul these players. They're going to have to foul. Otherwise, they can just dribble it out.
It looks like that might be the strategy here.
59 seconds. Down five. Can they get a quick three to stop?
We have a steal by Jose Pacheco, and we're coming the other way. A timeout by the seminarian team.
And we ask that you stick around at the end of the game. Whoever wins, we're going to be able to get down to the court, talk to them. We're going to have the presentation of the trophy, MVP, and we'll be able to talk to some of the fans here at the gym and hear their opinion. Let us know what they thought of the game.
Welcome to all on live stream.
If you don't mind, if the seminarians do hold on to this lead, I will have no part in the post-game celebration.
That's okay. The priests come back. We'll still join up. It's okay.
I think the way you should look at it, Father, is if the seminarians win this game, these are your future brother priests, which means that in time, they will be playing on the priest's team. And then the priest will be unstoppable.
You know, Miguel, I have looked at it from that point of view for a long time, and it still is not helping, okay? Because what they do is they send our best players to Rome, Brian Humphrey, Father Brian Humphrey.
Shout out to Father Brian, who might there be watching. Probably not.
Well, he's probably sleeping. Father Brian Humphrey's a priest, a good friend of mine, and a lot of us from the seminary. And he was ordained a few years ago, was a parish priest for 2 years, then he was sent to study in Rome. He's there studying for his a degree in systematic theology to come back and be a professor at the seminary. He was one of the star players on the priest team.
He may be watching. It's 6 o'clock over there, 6 a.m.
That is true. He may have tuned in.
45 seconds left. 5-point deficit. That's.
Priests are just attacking the ball. We've got a foul. We're going to the line. Clock stops.
39 seconds here.
Oh, we're not in the bonus.
Or maybe a two on a defensive start.
Matt Steller out to Father Justin O of St. Gertrude.
3-point attempt by Justin O is there.
Father Andrew there to get it. Father Justin again.
Nope.
Too short again.
Father Masteller, oh, right in the hands of Tommy Green, though. Out to Father, or out
got
to Michael.
They try to foul, but no one's calling fouls. There we go. We got a foul call, finally.
There we go. 10 seconds.
So, what do you think, Father?
Well, I think the referees went into the typical last-minute, let's get this game done, and they should have been calling fouls because the priests were actually trying to foul, but it doesn't matter because this is it's a 5-point insurmountable lead at this point.
I'm happy you're coming around, Father.
And out for 6 points.
I'm a realist, Miguel.
There you go.
If there's one thing, Dr. Vincelette taught me in philosophy class, it's to be a realist.
Dr. Vincelette, one of the philosophy professors at St. John's.
Possibly the only thing I learned in philosophy.
Well, there you go.
And we actually do have a few philosophy professors here watching tonight.
Oh. 49-42, 10 seconds
49-42, the clock is back running.
Thank you, Sunger.
8 seconds.
One last. Oh!
And there's another foul.
That was a
they called
foul.
That one.
That definitely was.
The seminarians are now trying to hurt the priests in the final seconds of the game, which I find just
and
ruthless.
Not just psychologically,
but emotionally.
Emotionally. But there's some physicality there going, too. Father Justin.
Not sure if the priests have a game plan to score 7 points in the last 3 seconds of the game, but if they do, they better incorporate it.
See what happens here.
It's over. That's what I'm trying to say.
It could evaporate. We'll see.
And
that is it.
Congratulations, St. John Seminary.
Congratulations again to Team Seminary. Seminarians. We want to thank you all for joining us on this live stream. We ask you to stick around a little longer for the presentation of the trophy, the presentation of MVP. And as we said, and we can see down on the court, that fraternity really does live on, though,
amen,
past this game. For an eternity up here with us.
And fraternity here.
We've really
Steven
enjoyed it.
And Miguel, I had a great time. Thanks for inviting
Matt.
Me
Thank
into
you,
the game.
Thank you for inviting him to the game.
If not for good commentary, at least for comic relief. Right?
We've had a good time. And as we said, next year, both Miguel and I will be deacons out of the seminary. And who knows who we'll be rooting for.
I love
so,
it.
Well,
we know who we'll be rooting for.
We do know who we'll be rooting for.
Let's not kid ourselves.
That's true.
Yeah, I want to give a quick shout out to anyone from Our Lady of Malibu who may be tuning in tonight. So, my beautiful people down there, the beautiful children of God of Our Lady of Malibu. Thank you for watching.
So receiving the trophy is Pepe Sikovic, a first-year seminarian. We interviewed him for just a second a bit ago. He's from my home parish, so he's a brother from the home parish. MVP going to Tommy Green. Makes sense. He scored many of the points tonight. He was truly unstoppable.
Let's do a group picture with all of you together. Group photo with everyone together.
But next year, he might not be considered everyone a seminarian to play as a deacon. So I don't know if next year the deacons will be playing on a seminarian team or...
Father Deacon would disqualify him, but they're still seminarians until they ordain or the Archbishop lays hands on them. So I would imagine they'd be playing for the seminarian team.
So we hope everybody at home has enjoyed themselves watching the game, hearing the commentary. In a moment, Stephen will be interviewing some of the players. I think he possibly interviewed the MVP. Last year, we interviewed one of some of the coaches, so we'll see. I did lose Stephen. I can't see him. But he is working his way to interview somebody.
Thank you, Father Matt and Miguel and Stephen for the live stream. Our live stream crew.
Thank you, guys. It was a beautiful night. Thank you for watching us tonight, supporting, praying for vocations. May God, if he's calling you, have the courage to answer yes to his call, but all of us call to holiness and service in the church.
That's wonderful. We appreciate you. We want to shout out, say hi to.
Yes, to St. Raymond's Life Team and Jen and our amazing parishioners at St. Raymond's and Downey. God bless you guys.
That's great. Thank you. Let's see if we can go ahead and catch one of our priests here. And let's see. Father Jihun. You've had a large group from St. Kateri.
Yes.
And they came out to support Michael. But I think some of them might have been here to support you, too. What do you have to say?
I'm just very grateful for all of them just come to support, you know, pursue the vocation, you know, whether it's Michael or me, right? Seminaries or priests, doesn't matter. They came to, support pursue the vocation. So
it is great. Well, you played great out there.
Thank you.
I know that the parish was really proud of you. Your family, well... they're praying for you.
That was a good thing that I wasn't injured. That was one of your concerns.
That was one of the diocese concern, but everyone's concerned.
Because I have to celebrate Mass tomorrow.
There you go. Yes. Well, we want to thank you for your time.
You.
Thank you for playing. And we're going to go find one of the seminarians.
Okay. Thank you, Steven.
Thank you. And let's see if we can find Dr. Libby Reichart, the mastermind of the seminarians' win here. See if we can get a hold of her again, like we did last year. Find out the winning strategy. If you want to follow us, we'll see if we can get a hold of her. Dr. Reichart, with some of her fans over here, for our live stream audience at home, they're rooting for you. You led this team to victory. How do you feel? Are you taking them to Disney World?
I'm so proud of our men. Like, they've worked hard for the last month and a half, and it really showed tonight.
They did. Now, does Tommy Green get an extra credit point for every basket he scored, or is it only every other?
That's a private agreement.
So. Okay.
And I just want to say something about what I'm wearing tonight. So we talked with the other coaches about what colors to wear, and I decided to wear all black because I wanted the priest to know how much I love them, and I wanted a visible reminder of my love for them because I thought they might forget it once we started wiping the floor with them. So.
And you did.
No, the priests came out strong and they played
did.
A good they, game. They had
really
us on our
did.
toes yes, the entire game.
They did. Okay. Well, next year, keep it up.
Thank you,
okay. And let's see if we can find our MVP 2 years in a row now, Tommy Green. Let's see if we can find him. Oh. He's got some of his great fans here with him. And we're going to sneak in his photo, see what happens here. Tommy. Sorry, we're going to steal him for just a minute for our live stream audience here. Vinny. Tommy, how do you feel?
Thirsty. And hungry more, no.
Thirsty for the
hungry
win?
Hungry for a pizza, no.
Now, next year you will be ordained a deacon and no longer in the seminary. What's going to happen? Are you taking a year off? Are you retiring?
There's no years off.
Are you
No.
So are we going to have seminarians versus deacons versus priests?
And we're word on the street, it's supposed to be moved to October, so then the deacons can play both the seminary team. Yeah, so I'll be back.
Okay.
Hopefully.
Very good. Okay. And anyone you want to say hi to, St. Gertrude was supporting you in great numbers. They really were. Could you feel
their God.
Prayers?
St. Dorothy's parishioners. I know they're doing a watch party right now.
That's great.
All the St. Elizabeth parishioners, my family and friends, and everybody who's watching. Thank you.
Wonderful. Okay, go get some water.
All right.
You sound like you need it. Okay. Well, we want to thank you guys for joining us on this live stream. We encourage you guys to try to make it again next year in person. If you can't, we want to encourage you to keep watching. Miguel, anything you want to add before we cut out here?
Just thanks for all your support. We ask that you keep praying, not only for all of the priests here, but also pray for the seminarians as they endure in their vocation so that they can make it to ordination, God willing. And so then they can be not only on the priest team, but also be good and faithful priests, because that's really what we want, and that's really what we're aspiring to do here, spread the awareness of vocations.
Absolutely.
So if you know somebody, or if you yourself are a young man interested in the priesthood, please, by all means, contact the vocation office, and we can walk with you in this journey.
That's a great pitch. And again, before we sign out, I do just want to say one thing, because we had a lot of fun with Father Matt. We had a lot of fun kind of poking fun at priests, at seminarians. It really is all out of love for each other. We really do love one another. We love what we're doing. And so hopefully everybody knows we're just taking this lightly, having a good time. But what we are serious about is our commitment to the church. We are serious about our commitment to the priesthood, about our vocation, about building up our parish communities with events like this. We want to thank you guys again once more for watching with us, for being here on the live stream. And we hope you can join us, and we'll keep you in our prayers. And we ask that you keep all of us in our prayers as we work towards ordination, discerning God's will for us, what he has planned, and our vocation. So thank you guys all for watching. And
go Team Seminarians.
Go Team Seminarians. Okay. Thank you so much. Bye.